Hello, everyone. I'm Zhao Chuang. Let's draw a juvenile Tarbosaurus today. Tarbosaurus was rare among tyrannosaurs with its juvenile fossils found. First of all, the juvenile Tarbosaurus looked very different from the adults, with a sharper head and a more flexible body. After assembling its full skeleton, people found that its legs were much longer than those of an adult, and it looked like a small, fast-running carnivorous dinosaur. Therefore, many scientists believe that after Tarbosaurus entering into adulthood, its body would be particularly strong, hindering its running. So the adult Tarbosaurus were better at ambush, while juveniles were better at hunting like a cheetah. In childhood, Tarbosaurus might have fluff on its body for warm keeping. Regarding its coloration, its juveniles looked fancier. We can take reference to the flightless birds like the ostrich or emu. When they were young, the stripes on their bodies helped them hide in the grass. Now, let's draw the juvenile Tarbosaurus. First, we start with its head. Its head is about this big in the picture. Its head was very pointed, very different from the adults. We know that adult Tarbosaurus had square heads, while the head of the juveniles was a triangle. We draw the nose first. It had a very pointed nose tip, and very small nostrils. Moving upward, there might be some small bumps above the nose, but not as well developed as those of an adult. Moving further upward, we draw a very large eye socket in this position, and we also need to draw the eye correspondingly larger. Then we show the skin around the eye. In front of the eye was its anteorbital fenestra, which might be covered by a soft skin like that of some birds. Then we draw the shape of its mouth, which was very pointed. Here was its jugal bone, and behind its eye was its temporal fenestra, which was very small. We only need to roughly know that shape. The juveniles might have feathers on their bodies. Then, we draw its teeth. Compared with adults, its teeth were very small and sharp, not the same as the very thick teeth of adults. The lower jaw was thin. And its masseter and cheek muscles were less developed than those of an adult. Let's add more details and perfect the keratinous part. There were no lacrimal horns developed, but only a small lump in front of the eyes. Slightly show the large scales above the mouth. Next, draw some fur behind the eyes. Note that there was a lump above the eyes. Generally, there was no hair on the part with the lump, so we leave it white. Like some vultures, its feathers grew in this position. Around the eyes, they grew along the second half of the circle. Then, we draw its body, the neck. Due to the feathers, the shape of its entire body appeared smoother, rounder, and fuller. Its body might also be covered with fluff. Then, we draw its thighs and two forelimbs. The forelimbs might be buried in the fluff. Next, we draw the tiny claws. The legs of Tarbosaurus might have looked longer in childhood than in adulthood. Draw its legs a little longer. The proportion was also different from the adults. And its feet were correspondingly larger. Draw some large scales on the instep and the back of the toes. Moving backward, we draw its tail, which might not have much fur on the underside, but had some fluff on the sides and above. Its shank skin might be exposed, resembling an ostrich. We can refine these parts a little bit. Like the juveniles of some birds, such as the ostrich or the emu, we draw stripes on its body as camouflage. Whether it's an ostrich, or an emu, or a cassowary, many land-walking birds usually have various patterns on their bodies to allow their juveniles to hide in bushes or vegetation. So we draw some patterns on the juvenile Tarbosaurus. Good, like this, we've finished drawing this juvenile Tarbosaurus.